Is it true that audiophiles are mad about cables?
I think in the UK, audiophiles give a lot more attention to cables, yes. There is a difference in cables, yes. You can hear it. It's really clear. When you change cables in a certain setup, you can tell the difference. Okay, for example, this cable would be about 150 pounds. It's a digital interconnect. It uses HPOCC copper, and that's copper that's cast in a particular way so that it's one long crystal of metal. Now, typically, you would have a piece of wire would have a lot of crystals in it, so the signal has more resistance. This reduces the resistance, you get a better signal, and it results in a different, better sound. These are speaker cables. These are different, again, HPOCC copper, but these have an air dielectric. So what happens is that the copper conductor is actually surrounded by air, which is a fantastic dielectric and insulator, and then you have this very stiff sheath to support that. And these are for speakers, and this box, 500 pounds or so, but there is a difference.
500 pounds?
Yeah, two cables, 2 meters each, 500 pounds.
Are these the most expensive cables you have?
No, the most expensive cable I have is connected to this beautiful looking piece of kit. And let me show you, it's not as sexy as the blue cable.
Sex appeal is a factor in cables, you think?
Absolutely. Look at the design of this kit. It's beautiful, and you want cables to complement the beauty of this
design. But the cables are behind the kit. So
often they are, but the speaker cables, they run along the carpet. You want something that glitters as well. It's 280 pounds, solid silver, HPOC, so it's cast as a single crystal of silver.
I've heard of people spending up to, £2,000 a meter on cabling.
Yeah, you can do that.
I think that's a bit excessive.
You know, people are buying cars which are £250,000.
But you know, cars can drive you from A to B. I mean, cables, you can't drive a cable, right?
But a car that costs £5,000 will drive you from A to B. You know, if you have a car at £250,000, you want a cable in the car's audio system which will deliver the goods, you know, in the same way. You can hear the difference. Chalk and cheese.
Chalk and cheese.
What is an audiophile? One who, I suppose, thinks very deeply about the equipment which he buys or would like to buy to reproduce the music, and somebody who is keen to experiment, and that sometimes becomes an end in itself.
Well, I've seen some unusual things. Really unusual things that are supposed to change the way sound gets into the environment, the way it can be identified, even being able to make images from sound.
Things like worrying about, for instance, whether a particular part of a sound scene is in the right plane, whether it should be further forward, further back, and worrying about that kind of thing seems to me entirely pointless.
Characters that I've experienced in the past have suggested that by the quality of the sound they can generate, human form. I think what they were getting at is that the sound was so genuine, was so lifelike. Because they're all seeking, aren't they, to make things lifelike. Is that it was possibly so lifelike that it generated the actual image in the room. Anyway, I couldn't see an image, but I suppose that is what they're all aiming to secure.
And what happened to this particular fella?
He was sectioned. So, bless him. He was a really nice guy, actually. But he was quite an extreme character, so I think it got the better of him.
Do you think he's still institutionalized?
I suspect he's let out on occasions too, and he's not harmful at all, but they thought he was. But you do find that sort of character in this trade, extreme characters who can passionately discuss what they're doing and how it differs with the rest. And
we're interested in the passion of audiophiles. Do you consider yourself an audiophile?
I'm absolutely dedicated to the perfection of reproduced sound. Audiophile sometimes includes more faith than hard understanding.
Okay, so you're more of a scientist.
I would say so.
Can you give me an example of some of this faith thing you're talking about?
Actually, no. No, I don't want to start.
I mean,
it's dangerous, Graham.
You mean it's the stuff that's not really measurable, is that what you
mean? No, that's right. Now I'll get onto terribly difficult territory, and I'm going to cut that out of the interview because we get onto. I don't.
Do you think some of these audiophiles are addicts or have obsessive compulsive disorder? Some kind of.
Good question. I'm sure there are a few, and every. Hi-fi dealer, every distributor will know some of them, maybe even most of them. But I think, you know, you can take that too far an extent, and it can indeed become an obsession.
Has it ever got to the point where it seems to be a bit like a drug, I suppose?
Yes. I am agreeing that I believe that there are people out there who... probably displaying classic symptoms of addiction, and yes, then you could say that it is acting as a drug. I don't see ourselves, however, as peddlers, and yes, there is always that possibility that every upgrade that you implement is an improvement, and therefore I think there is an upgrade addiction syndrome. And I'm sure there's some element of the retail therapy psychology there, that if you go out and spend money, you get a little buzz.
What do you think that the experience people are trying to achieve is? It must be something pretty special if it costs that much.
Well, as I say, it's to feel transported to the original performance, and to not be reminded that you are actually listening to a reproduced performance. And those reminders can take the form of distortions that creep in as you reach high levels, or coloration.
Do you think that the music ever approaches something that you might describe as a spiritual experience? Yes. or rapture?
Yeah, you can experience true ecstasy whilst listening to a reproduced performance on a piece of hi-fi equipment, yeah, for sure. Yeah, spine-tingling moments. Well, we wouldn't do it if we didn't. If we didn't experience that on occasions, yeah.
With joy.